Hey, what's up guys? Bajheera here. Got another Middle Earth Shadow of Mordor video for you guys. And in the last video, I took you guys through the basics of like the Nemesis system, where you can pick out certain orcs that you'd like to slay. And in this one, we're gonna jump right into it, because I'm tracking down two guys in particular that are in generally the same area. And I'm gonna go after this guy first things first. Naskuga the Messenger. So you can see he's got a nice quiver of arrows on his back, blocked my attack with his crossbow. So we pretty much already know that this guy is an archer. So we did know some intel about him, but I wanted to see what I could do if I get in there and mix it up with him. Now what I see right there is I see one of the Uruks trying to raise the alarm for the entire stronghold, which means that, you know, obviously if they raise the alarm, what do you think is going to happen? They're going to call out tons of Uruks, and I'm going to be, you know, probably dealing with more than I can handle. And interestingly enough, this guy, one of his strengths is that he calls out a lot of help whenever he's attacked. So I made the mistake. I'm just going to go ahead and say it. I made the mistake of trying to fight this guy head on, knowing full well that he is vulnerable to ranged attacks. And he also calls out an entire horde of guys to try to help him out when he is attacked. So even though I'm able to get him pretty low, and he is also vulnerable to melee finishers, so I have him in position to finish him here, but unfortunately there are just too many enemies for me to really get a solid finisher on him. So I take a hit, I'm able to spacebar block this one right here. It does give you a chance when you are downed to fight your way through, as long as you can meet that mouse cursor requirement and then pressing a button at the right time. I was waiting until right at the last moment to press it, but I'm fairly confident it's fine if you just go ahead and press a button as soon as you can. I'm poisoned here. I have no idea how to block this thing. I don't even know if I have the option to block this thing, and I'm overwhelmed and killed by this Uruk named Rosh. Now, one of the most interesting things about this game is when you die, you don't just respawn and, you know, you go on with your life as if nothing happened. No, the enemies that killed you get promoted and more powerful in Sauron's army. So, you can see that one guy who killed me went, got a power up, got promoted. The one who survived my attack, you know, got credit for surviving and got more powerful. And then two other Uruks got promoted to captain just by being part of slaying me, right? Because you, as the ranger, you can hear as you're running around, a lot of the Uruks will be talking about you, like, oh, watch out for the ranger, or, oh, I thought I heard him around. You gotta be, you know, on guard, or they're talking smack about, like, oh, I could kill the ranger if only I could find him. But anyway, you are a topic of discussion for these Uruks. And so when you are slain, obviously, that is a big deal to them and in their society. And in the Uruk society, you know, it's definitely a militaristic society. What they value in their society is, you know, strength, valor, victory in combat. So being killed by one of them is definitely a boon for them in terms of their hierarchical rating. So, having made the mistake of trying to attack this guy right out of the middle of the open, sort of overestimating my battle prowess, underestimating their ability to respond to it, I'm trying to take a little bit more of a sneaky approach. You can see that he has a little bit of damage on his health bar, and a lot of the Uruks are looking around to see where they can find me. So what I'm going to try to do here is I'm going to try to get a few pot shots on him while he is sort of still unaware, while I still have the element of surprise. So I'm going to try to whittle his health down a little bit, trying to get that headshot. So right now, my abilities, my range abilities are not killing him as well as I'd like. So perhaps I should have checked my strengths and weaknesses to see that perhaps he's not weak to ranged attacks. Even though if he's not weak to them, even though he doesn't get one-shotted by them, it's still valuable to me, I think, to try to whittle him down a little bit. I see that his health is regenning when I'm not hitting him, so you gotta keep that in mind. But it's not regenning too fast, so it's still worth it to harass him and then to hide back in the shadows again, taking a bit more of a patient, stealthy approach to this, because I do want to whittle him down, because I know when I do have a chance to kill him, my window is going to not be very large. So I do see a marauding Uruk patrolling here. I'm going to try to take him out before he alerts his friends, and plus I don't want to have anybody messing with me while I'm trying to use that vantage point to secure the kill. But one of his friends does see me, so I'm going to try to make a quick getaway, but my attempt to make a getaway does alert me to the fact that this guy is pretty much all alone here. So I'm gonna go ahead and hop into stealth in this bush. I'm gonna track him a little bit more, and I'm gonna go ahead and jump him right here. So, once again, our little dialogue is a little bit different than before. So, he says, "You're all alone," which is kind of funny because, you know, he definitely is not alone. He calls for his army whenever he's in trouble. So, he whipped out his little horn bugle. However, I do have a few moments alone with him, and it's up to me to capitalize on it right now. So, I'm going to start whipping up my combos. I really want to try to build some combo points, some streak points there, so that I can hopefully get a melee execute on him. Once again, he does call for his horde, and interestingly enough, Rosh Lockjaw, see, he says, "Didn't I kill you already?" So he recognizes me. He knows. He's the guy who actually got the kill on me last time. So I'm noticing that there are two captains here, tons of Uruks. I'm going to have to make a little bit of a getaway. This mission is definitely proving a little bit harder than I expected. And that's something that's actually a lot of fun because, you know, in the beginning of the game, I'm still very, very early in the game. But, you know, you get your first few kills, you get your first few battles, you're feeling your oats, and then you try to take a mission that involves two Uruk captains in the middle of their stronghold, and, you know, things get a little bit more real for you. But in this challenge of this game, you know, how am I going to take on this particular challenge? That's the kind of thing that makes it a lot of fun. So you saw that I did take down the first captain I was trying to attack pretty low, but then his friend Rosh decided to join the fray, and I had to make my retreat. So what I'm trying to do now is I'm trying to find a way that I can perhaps maybe find some arrows. Like, there's an arrow right there. I can hopefully maybe grab that and use that to snipe this guy, get his health down a little bit lower, so I can jump down there and get a nice combat finisher on him, which does seem to be his weakness. So I'm going to take this guy out real quick, do that death from above kill, hop up on here, do a little bit of platforming. The platforming in this game is really, really enjoyable. It's really, really smooth and fun, and it is a blast just to be able to sprint through the environment. You know, if ever you get in trouble, like right here, I did not realize that there were a bunch of Uruks here, so I'm going to have to try to make a clean getaway here. I do jump in there, just give him one quick get off of me smack with my sword, and that's off to the races for me. So what you know is you can, interestingly enough, see the last position they knew where you are. So that gives you an idea of how far away you need to escape in order to be completely undetected. So you can see from all the little yellow arrows at the bottom of my screen that they saw me and they're on the lookout for me, but they don't exactly know where I am. So I'm still in a little bit of a getaway position, but I do get a chance to get a nice clear shot on this guy. Two headshots. Well, it looks like one of them went right through the neck, so a nice headshot and a nice neck shot are going to score me the kill on him. However, my problem of wanting to kill both of them, because, hey, you know, if you go on a mission and you end up dying, obviously, well, at least for me, I'm going to want some revenge. So, I know that I am not going to let this guy get out alive. So what I'm going to do is, with my second arrow shot, I'm going to shoot down one of those little hanging carcasses, and that's going to call out a ton of Karagors who are going to help thin the herd a little bit, so I can have maybe a one-on-one chance to kill this guy who killed me last time. So I'm just going to watch for right now, make sure that I don't have any more arrows, so I can't really just continue the rain of pain on this guy. But that one arrow did strike true. His health is hurting a little bit, but I'm just going to bide my time right now. Nobody is tracking me right now. Nobody can see me. Really, all I have to do right now is find a way to maybe perhaps get some more arrows. So I might be looking to get the drop on this guy, figuratively and literally, so I can drain him of his life force and replenish my elf shots. So I'm going to sneak up on him, but instead of just killing him, I might just try to drain his life. So I'm going to hit him with the one drain to get my arrows, and I'm out of there. So I'm not even worried about killing him. Maybe I'll come back and drain him a little bit later. He's still mad at me. I'm looking for a way to platform out of this. I got to run around there, hop up on the cage. I don't think I want to release this Karagor just yet, but I do want to make sure I can run across here, get up all the way high up here, because even though these Uruk know that I'm here, it's going to be really difficult for them to reach me. So hopefully if I can just hang out over here a little bit longer, I'll be okay. So I feel safe enough that I can whip out the bow. I am going to shoot down one of these nests of stinging insects, which will scatter the Uruk even more, and I'm going to release another Karagor on them, which hopefully will soften them up a little bit more and give me a chance to get a few more pot shots. So I have two arrows. One lands, one misses, but it's looking like he's all isolated. All of his friends have died. Looks like my time to strike. I'm going to get in there on this guy, and I'll see what I can do. Unfortunately, my plans to get the Karagor involved in the battle somewhat backfire. even though, you know, I released them, I am in between them and their original prey. So this instantly starts to be a situation that is a bit rough for me. I've got this guy. I'm thinking about draining him to try to kill him, but his friend interrupts me just in time, and the Caragor comes back and nearly mauls me to death. Luckily, my kill target does knock him back just a little bit, giving me time to time my roll underneath the Caragor, and then once again try to make an escape. So, once again, you know, good thinking, unleashing my, using my environment to my advantage, trying to unleash some of those Caragors onto the giant swarm of Uruks in the main area there that were defending my my prey, if you will. But once again, he has rallied the troops. They know where I am. You can see that sort of silhouette right there. So, in a daring move, I'm gonna try to run down here. I never collected the rune that I got from defeating my original opponent. But I want to go grab that real quick, and then I'm gonna try to platform my way through the middle again, and try to find a place where I can hopefully find a little bit of refuge and plan my next assault. So I'm circling back around. They still lots and lots of Uruk down there, but I am once again going to use this technique of shooting down Caragor, little bait right there. But can you see all of those guys? I'm sure that they sounded the alarm on me. And hopefully, once again, I can use that as a distraction. I'm going to shoot a nest down there. I think it's a little bit far away. It does seem to be affecting those guys, but I'm pretty sure it just scares them away. I don't really think it injures them all that much. But as you can see, my mark has tons of defense around him right now. So I'm looking for a way that I can... One of my goals right now is to isolate him. And obviously, unleashing the Caragors on them is pretty effective. But I still have the problem of finding a way to get down there and kill him. So even though I do have a good idea of his strengths and weaknesses, right now, what I'm more concerned with is just the logistics of the thing. How am I going to put myself in position to kill this guy? And this, obviously... is part of the game, right? You get to play your mission, you know, as you please. So if you're a stealthy kind of guy, right now, you know, I really don't mind getting in there and mixing it up, but I do recognize my limits. That is too many for me to just get in there and brawl with. But there's another side of it, is that the stealthy aspect is a lot of fun. You know, lining up your shots, figuratively and literally, is a lot of fun for me. So I, you know, and this is definitely going to be something that's fun for you guys too, is picking how you'd like to deal with these missions right now. So some of you guys might be watching like, oh my gosh, just go sneak up on him and kill him. Or if you could just get some arrows from your surroundings, then you could eventually take him out. And that's actually one of the things that I'm doing right now. One of his sort of bodyguards ended up leaving him behind a little bit. So it gives me a nice clear window to snipe from. So he's going to run at me. Once again, he runs right over to me, and I think this is my chance. I'm going to get a nice death from above on him. He's not going to be able to score the kill with that. However, right now I have a really good chance to have it be just him and me, one-on-one. Don't get a chance to kill him yet. I was going for the kill. But once again, I'm going to hit him with a couple finishers, maybe get enough combo points to hit him with an execute. I'm trying to scare off all his guys, trying to fight through. This is my chance. I am getting hit from behind, but I finally might be able to get a chance just to hack him to pieces, score the killing blow with a nice slash. Now the trick is, how am I going to collect my reward and get out of here alive? Obviously, I'm not going to be able to just sit there and loot that thing right this instant, so I need to make a bit of a getaway. I know that is a destructible barrel right there. I'm hopping over the Uruks, but I know I need to make a getaway. I see that's a destructible barrel. I know they're going to be running my way. I'm going to hop up here. I'm going to take a quick 1-2, knock this guy off of my post, aim at the barrels, explode all of those enemies, hop down there like an absolute badass. Claim my reward, and find a way to get out of here scot-free. So, obviously, guys, that was a pretty challenging mission for me. And it wasn't a story mission. It was just, hey, I'm going to try to kill one of these guys. I ended up failing the first time, made three guys get promoted, and definitely not what I wanted to have happen. So, obviously, I'm going to have to get back in there, figure out how to get revenge on all of those guys, and there is one guy still left standing, but believe you me, I took him out after this video. But anyways, guys, this game definitely is a blast. Offers you tons of really neat opportunities to decide how you want to go about your missions, how you want to play your game, and needless to say, that makes for a very fun gaming experience. And gives this game a lot of replayability. Obviously, you can play that through that storyline, and that's something that I'm excited to do, but I cannot get over how much fun just hunting down these Uruk captains are, because you know, each assassination attempt is a pretty awesome experience, and something I hope that you guys decide to check out. And of course, there are links in the description for you to check this game out if you'd like to. But once again, guys, I'm going to wrap up this video for now. Thank you guys so much for watching, and look forward to plenty more Middle-earth Shadow of Mordor videos in the future. Until next time, guys, thanks for watching, and peace!